The following presentation is a non-profit parody inspired by Brian Fargo's Fallout containing music from other outside sources. All rights belong to their original owners. Please support the official releases.
Swallows come back to Capistrano. That's the day you promised to come back to me. When you whispered farewell in Capistrano, was the day the swallows flew out to the sea.
War. War never changes. As the radioactive Holocaust came to an end, mankind struggled to gain its foothold in the world that was ravaged by thermonuclear weapons on a nightmarish scale. But as time passed and as some semblance of society has made its way into the Californian wasteland, a new threat has emerged. You are the Vault Dweller, and on your quest to retrieve the water for your vault, you were apprehended by super-mutants in the necropolis. You are now being sent to God knows where.
Okay. Take off the blindfold. I wish to speak to this human. Oh, this is excellent. You know, I actually doubted my officers when they said they'd captured a prime normal. It's so nice to see you.
Go to hell.
Well, this prime normal seems to have had such a way with words.
The mutant lieutenant mutters with a slight grin on his face. His robotic eye zooms in on your face. He can tell you are nervous from the sweat on your brow.
Nervous, are we?
No. Why would I be nervous of a big freak like you, you big red bastard?
The lieutenant clutches his chest. He flutters his eyes and puts his other hand on his forehead as if he were a southern belle about to faint from heat exhaustion.
Oh my, such attitude. By God, you are such a feisty normal.
What do you want with me?
Well, isn't it obvious? I want to know where your vault is, and I want to know more about you. Tell me, human, have you ever been lonely before?
What?
Have you ever just wanted somebody?
What are you talking? The Vault Dweller is suddenly cut off by the mutant's oncoming wall of exposition.
This is a transition slide.
I was born in a shack to an abusive father. When my father figured out about my sexual preferences, he kicked me out of the house during the darkest solar eclipse in years. Son, you are a faggot. You also like men. Get out of my shack. And so I wandered through the wastes, alone, yay, and hungry. It wasn't until a week later that I was taken in by the master, dipped, and finally had a place of my own.
Oh my God, that's so sad.
The Vault Dweller looks into the mutant's oversized eyes and notices some warmth. You feel slightly more at ease.
Thank you for your empathy. Things were not always great here, though. Especially after one of the Mr. Handy bots started dealing me heroin, and I joined the Puerto Rican street gang around. Thank you, human. Because of you, I'll never do black tar heroin again. How can I ever repay you?
I don't know, maybe a day out, you know?
I wouldn't have gone out with anyone else. Wow, I haven't had this much fun in years.
Yeah, me too. No, you don't really sound that excited. You still sound kind of creepy.
Well, I mean, that's the point. You know, the fun doesn't have to end there.
The mutant raises one eyebrow in a suggestive fashion. He puts his hand on your shoulder and slowly slides it down, resting gently on your ass.
Oh, I see. Well, come and get me.
I'm here, and I'm ready. You need to conserve your energy, because I'm going to dip into you. I am coming.
A year has passed since the couple have met. They have settled down and things have been going smoothly, yet there have been some temptations.
Harry brings more humans. No ghouls this time, like Lou said. Also, where is Lou?
Lieutenant? He'll be back in an hour.
You see,
only want to say hi to my Harry, Happy.
Harry can't wait forever!